Hi everyone. Previous class we have discussed about applications of the Bayer-Sevier law. In this class we are going to discuss about next application of the Bayer-Sevier law, that is magnetic field intensity H bar on the axis of a circular loop. In the previous class we have discussed about magnetic field intensity on the center of the circular loop. So now here the application is find out the magnetic field intensity on the axis of a circular loop. Let us consider current carrying the conductor. The current carrying the conductor is arranged in the form of the circular loop. That current carrying conductor is located in placed in z is equal to 0 plane, that is xy plane, and the radius of the circular loop is small r. At any point on the circular loop, consider the point P1. At that point P1, dl bar is the differential vector length. So draw the line from origin to the point P. That distance is small r. That small r is the radius of the circular loop. So now here in this application, the magnetic field intensity is calculated on the axis of the circular loop. So consider the point P on the z axis at a distance z meters from the origin. At this point P, we can determine magnetic field intensity and magnetic flux density at a distance z meter from the origin. So draw the line from elementary length to the point P. That distance is capital R, and a suffix capital R bar is the unit vector. So this matter is explanation of the above figure that is already discussed. In cylindrical coordinate system, the differential in the dl bar is equal dr into ar bar plus r d pi into a y bar plus dz into a z bar. In differential length, in cylindrical coordinate system, the differential length dl bar is equal dr into ar bar plus r d pi into a pi bar plus dz into a z bar. Now here on the circular loop, at any point on the circular loop, the differential length dl bar is varying in tangential direction, that is a pi bar direction. So therefore, the differential vector length dl bar is equal r d pi into a pi bar. dl bar is the differential vector length. I into dl bar is the differential current element. I into dl bar is equal I r d pi into a pi bar. The unit vector ar bar is in the direction along the line joining the differential current element to the point P. Ar bar is the unit vector. The direction is along the joining, along the line joining differential current element to the point P. So therefore, the unit vector ar bar is equal magnitude of r bar divided by magnitude of r bar. So calculate distance vector capital R bar and magnitude of r bar and unit vector ar bar from the figure. First, calculate the distance vector capital R bar from the figure. So, from this figure, calculate the distance vector capital R bar. How to calculate the distance capital R bar from the figure, and small r is the radius of the circular loop. Now here the magnetic field intensity is calculated at point P. That point P is on the z axis. All the unit vectors are moving towards point P. Now here what are the unit vectors? A suffix small r bar and a suffix z bar are the unit vectors. all the unit vectors are moving towards point P, that will be considered as a positive sign, otherwise it will be considered as a negative sign. Once again, I will explain the same point. Now here in this application, the magnetic field intensity and the magnetic flux density is calculated on the z-axis. All the unit vectors are moving towards point P, that will be considered as a negative sign, otherwise it will be treated or considered as a Now here the magnetic field intensity is calculated at point P on the z-axis. If the unit vectors are moving towards point P, that will be considered as a positive sign, otherwise it will be considered as a negative sign. Now here in this figure, the unit vector A suffix R bar is not moving towards point P, it is moving another direction. So it will be considered as a negative sign. Negative sign means minus A R bar. And what is the this distance from origin to the elemental length? This distance is small r, that distance into minus A R bar, minus R into A R bar plus, and A Z bar unit vector is moving towards point P. A Z bar unit vector is moving towards point P. So that will be considered as a positive sign plus A Z bar. From origin to the point P, what is the distance? Small z. So therefore, plus z into A Z bar. So this is the distance vector capital R bar from the figure, that is minus R A R bar plus z A Z bar. Next, take the magnitude on both sides. Magnitude of capital R bar is equal to square root of A R bar components, square root of A R bar component square plus A Z bar component square, that is minus R square plus Z square. Next, calculate the unit vector. The unit vector A suffix capital R bar is equal to R bar divided by magnitude of R bar. So R bar is minus R A R bar plus Z A Z bar. Magnitude of R bar is square root of R square plus Z square. So that is distance vector capital R bar and magnitude of R bar and unit vector A suffix capital R bar from the figure. Therefore, now calculate the cross product of dl bar cross ar bar value. So using matrix notation, the A bar and B bar are the two unit vectors that can be written in terms of matrix notation. Ax bar, Ay bar, Az bar, and A bar components and B bar component values. Now here the cylindrical coordinate system is there. In cylindrical coordinate system, dl bar cross r bar is equal ar bar, Ay bar, Az bar. And what is the dl bar? The differential vector length dl bar is equal r d pi into A pi bar. And ar bar component is 0. And A pi bar component is R D pi and A Z bar component is 0. So this is the differential vector length D L bar. So what is the direction of the differential vector length that is moving in A pi bar direction? D L bar is equal R D pi. So in this equation, A R bar component is 0, A Z bar component is 0 and A pi bar component is R D pi. And from the figure, the distance vector capital R bar. And this is the capital R bar from the figure. From this equation, A R bar component is minus R. Here there is no A pi bar component, that is 0, and A Z bar component is Z. And reducing RHS term of this equation, we get A R bar into this minus this into this minus A pi bar into this minus this into this plus A Z bar into this minus this into this. So we get dl bar cross r bar is equal r z d pi A r bar plus r square d pi A Z bar. According to Baer-Savart law, the differential magnetic field intensity at point P is given by dl bar is equal to I dl bar cross r bar by 4 pi r cube. So dl bar cross r bar value is already calculated, and substitute dl bar cross r bar value into this equation, we get dh bar is equal to I into dl bar cross r bar is R z d by r bar plus r square d by a z bar by 4 pi r cube. 4 pi r cube. So that is the code. And what is the magnitude of r bar? Square root of small r square plus z square, and substitute magnitude of r bar value here. We get I into rz d pi r bar plus r square d pi z bar divided by 4 pi. Magnitude of r bar is r square plus z square whole to the power of 1 by 2. So now your whole cube is there, because of that r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2. This is the differential magnetic field intensity. Now we want to calculate the total magnetic field intensity H bar at point B about the closed circular conductor, about closed circular current carrying conductor over 0 to 2 pi. Suppose the total magnetic field intensity H bar is equal to integrating H bar over 0 to 2 pi. So that is H bar is equal to integral pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi dh bar. And this is the dh bar value. Substitute dh bar value into here. We get h bar is equal to integral pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi I into rz d pi r bar plus r square d pi z bar by 4 pi into r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2. So that is equal to h bar is equal to I by 4 pi integral pi is equal to 0 to pi. So this equation is written as rz d pi r bar by r square plus z square all to the power of 3 by 2 plus I by 4 pi integral 0 to 2 pi r square d pi z bar by r square plus z square all to the power of 3 by 2. That is considered as equation 1. So h bar is equal to h1 bar plus h2 bar, where h1 bar is, and this is h1 bar and this is h2 bar. So first to calculate h1 bar. So this equation consists of, there are two components. What are the two components? One is ar bar component and another one is az bar component. So from these two components only consider one component and another component is neglected. Now here in this application, the magnetic field intensity is calculated on the z axis. So consider only az bar components, neglect ar bar component. So according to the derivation, first to calculate h1 bar. So consider the first integral term of the above equation. So due to the radial symmetry, h1 bar is equal I by 4 pi integral pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi rz d pi r bar by r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2. In rectangular coordinate system or the Cartesian coordinate system, the unit vector r bar, can be represented in terms of Cartesian coordinate system. R bar is equal cos pi ax bar plus sin pi ay bar. A bar is equal to cos pi ax bar plus sin pi ay bar. So now here differentiating, integrating with respect to pi, and remaining parameters are constant. So the above expression may also be written as I rz by 4 pi r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2 integral pi is equal to 0 to pi cos pi d pi ax bar plus integral pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi sin pi d pi ay bar. So integrating first term and applying the ranges of the pi, and integrating the second term applying the ranges of the pi, we get the resultant value is 0. So integral cos pi is sin pi over 0 to 2 pi, integral sin pi is minus cos pi over 0 to 2 pi. After applying the limits, finally we get h1 bar is equal to 0. After applying the upper value of pi and lower value of pi, the total, the H1 bar magnetic field intensity, H1 bar component is 0. And substitute this H1 bar value is equal to 0 into equation 1. We get from equation 1, H bar is equal to H2 bar. So that is equal. h bar is equal I by 4 pi integral pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi r square d pi az bar r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2. So now we are integrating with respect to pi. Remaining all the parameters are constant, that is written before integration. That is equal I by 4 pi I by 4 pi into r square by r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2 integral pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi 1 d pi az bar. Integral 1 d pi is pi over 0 to 2 pi. Applying the upper value of pi and lower value of pi, we get 2 pi minus 0 2 pi, and numerator and denominator 2 pi is the cancel, and the remaining expression h bar is equal I r square by 2 into r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2 az bar. And magnetic field intensity is measured in ampere per square meter. So this is the equation of the magnetic field intensity on the axis of the circular loop. This is the equation of the magnetic field intensity at point P on the axis of the circular loop. In this equation, small r is the radius of the circular loop and z is the distance of point P along the axis. Z is the distance from point P to the center of the circular loop, or the distance of point P along the axis. In previous class, we have already discussed magnetic field intensity at the center of the circular loop. So that is h bar is equal to I by 2r into an bar. So in this video, we discussed about magnetic field intensity on the axis of the circular loop from the above expression. So what is the above expression? Magnetic field intensity on the axis of the circular loop. So that is h bar is equal to I r square by 2 into r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2 az bar. So this is the equation of the magnetic field intensity h bar on the axis of the circular loop. Here z is the distance from origin to the point P. So from this equation, calculate the magnetic field intensity at the center of the circular loop. At the center of the circular loop, that point P, that axis point P is placed in the center of the, shifted to the center of the circular loop. So distance z is equal to 0. So in this equation, substitute z is equal to 0, we get the magnetic field intensity h bar on the center of the circular loop. So that is h bar is equal I by 2r into az bar ampere per meter square.